When we found out just a day ago that Rudy Giuliani had apparently been diagnosed with COVID-19, the odds of Jenna Ellis, co-lawyer for the president, getting it seemed to have gone up. They've been near each other quite recently, unmasked, with Rudy letting loose with flatulence nearby. And apparently, the COVID chickens have come home to roost. President Trump's lawyer, Jenna Ellis, has informed associates she has coronavirus. Multiple sources tell Axios, stirring West Wing fears after she attended a senior staff Christmas party on Friday. Let's stop there for just one second. A senior staff Christmas party on Friday. They had a Christmas party for their staff. That's madness.
It's madness, and it's just, yeah. I was thinking about the you know, I'm watching Heaven's Gate, and like, we're basically just witnessing a cult here where even the threat of death will not deter someone from getting together in a room with another person. If you can't threaten someone with death and change their behavior, what's gonna work? What would work?
Yeah, well, with these in general, I don't think anything. With these particular people, I think cutting off their grifty income might be more effective than the threat of death. But that's about it, really. Yeah,
maybe
they're
sick. Maybe the answer to basically deprogramming anyone in a cult is just cutting their meals.
Exactly. The issue with a cancel strategy in this case is that the only people who do believe that the threat of death should matter aren't the ones who have any sway over her, and we don't provide her income. So we're sort of defenseless or weaponless in this case. So but apparently,
let me ask you, who's handling all of the pressing, urgent legal proceedings now?
I mean, look, so Rudy Giuliani, I had heard, was supposed to be virtually involved in some sort of hearing as early as this morning. We don't know exactly what his condition is like. They say that he's feeling good and doesn't have a fever, but he also was almost immediately checked into a hospital. So that would then seem to throw it to Jenna Ellis, who supposedly has it. Although, let me run through a couple of these graphics, because she does dispute it, which is important, and we should acknowledge that. Bear in mind that three senior White House officials informed Axios of her diagnosis, leading to concerns that that party we talked about could become a super spreader event. She was apparently there, a guest of Peter Navarro, wasn't wearing a mask, because why would you? It's only the dark winter. We know that people brought their families there. Now, when Jonathan Swan asked Ellis about his reporting that she had tested positive and that some senior staff weren't happy about it, she replied that it was rude to text her after midnight, adding, "You must be more informed than me because I haven't heard it." So she denies that it's actually true. And by the way, I don't think that she was quarantining between when Rudy Giuliani was confirmed to have it and today. So will it actually change her behavior? That I don't know, if it turns out that she does.
You know, I support their First Amendment right to ignore a life-threatening virus. I really do. I support their ability to say whatever crap they would like to say. I just want them to get to the back of the line for the vaccine. I just think that that requires Pfizer or Moderna or whoever's controlling the lineup to move them to the rear of the line. You know what I'm saying? Kind of like the way I get turned away at Ralph's if I don't have my mask. I want them to sort of go to the back of the line or come back when they've basically gotten their attitudes right.
Yeah, I think that that makes a lot of sense. Unfortunately, I'm gonna say my gut tells me that there is going to be a direct correlation between how awful a person is and how quickly they get that vaccine. It's gonna be immediate.
I know, it is. It is a sad. They'll be first in line for that.
100%.
Yeah.
And so, look, we talked about yesterday on the show after it was revealed that Rudy Giuliani had it. Friend of the show, Emma Vigeland, she had tweeted about some of the sort of highlights of Rudy's last month or two, of the crazy things that he's done and been involved in. And Jenna Ellis attacked Emma, calling her evil for like wanting someone to get COVID, even though Emma didn't say anything like that. And the thing is, I don't want Jenna Ellis to have COVID. I don't even want Rudy Giuliani to have COVID. I've lost a family member to COVID. I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemies, and these are them. But at a certain point, like, they're worried now that that party is gonna be a super spreader event. They've already had two White House-based super spreader events, and they keep throwing parties. Mike Pompeo is gonna have a 900-person Christmas party. Like, at what point, like there's a big gap between wanting someone to have COVID and I guess saying, yeah, no, you did everything you could have possibly done to get it. Am I supposed to have empathy to spare at this point for these people?
Well, you're having a natural reaction as a human being with empathy, and I think that's terrific, and I commend you for it. I think there need to be consequences and repercussions, and typically, whatever those are, we're never going to learn of them factually anyway. So if, like, for instance, Giuliani's hair dye is running everywhere in the hospital room and he's really sick and he's, you know, on death's door, we'll never know because they'll somehow camouflage just how sick they are. But, you know, they always minimize how sick they get. And they're also getting access, as we know, to these sort of latest therapies. And the vampire blood, whatever they're drinking over there, baby blood, whatever, pig blood. So I don't think we'd ever know, but I think it's a very human reaction to want consequences.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want anyone to die, right? You don't want anyone to you just don't. But you know, I don't know. Giuliani's ex-wife might feel differently. I don't know.
Yeah. I think what you're talking about is sort of like that sort of primal impetus that leads to religion. It's this desire to live in a cause and effect, fact-based universe. That there will be patterns that we can discern, that behaviors will lead to predictable outcomes. We clearly don't live in that. Whether, you know, because they're all getting it and they're all basically surviving, except for Herman Cain. Whether it's the vampire blood or we've long talked about the monkey antibodies that they're clearly getting.
Yeah.
They always get something that perks them right back up and they're perfectly fine. But yeah.
And just even on the face of it, the cognitive dissonance that it requires to be someone who's in the faith and in the cult, where you basically, you see these people getting sick, you see them succumbing, and then yet you still believe that something is just like the flu. Or who gives a crap? I'm gonna go to this rally anyway and not wear a mask, or I'm gonna go to this event or a Christmas party. I mean, these are people. Here's the deal. What's that company that goes into buildings and sterilizes the whole place? You see those commercials? You know those guys?
That's like for bugs?
Yeah, for all kinds of stuff. Like when you have a sewer or you have some kind of a mite infestation or something.
I assume that was the mob that did that.
Think about what they're gonna do to the White House. It's literally like going into a frat house and having to like clean up all the beer bottles. You're like, you're gonna have to sterilize, you're gonna have to strip the paint. That place is a COVID nesting zone. There are parties, there are bedrooms. I mean, if I were Joe Biden, would you sleep in the bedroom? Would you go into the bathroom and take a shower?
I would bleach it myself. I don't like cleaning bathrooms. I would make an exception. Maybe the bedroom, the bed though.
Ooh.
No.
I wouldn't.
No.
I just wouldn't. You know, like after the inauguration, when he's supposed to go right back to the White House, I would do something like, thank you so much for the impressive house. It's really lovely, but my wife and I are gonna stay at the Hampton Inn just down the road.
Yeah, maybe make it the Four Seasons. Anyway,
sorry.
Yeah, exactly. I would clean that out. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.